Ken Molay here with a tip from the library. Using a pre-recorded video clip in your webinar can be a great way to add extra media-rich content. It can also really mess things up for you and your attendees. Let me help you think through the concerns. First and most importantly, check with your webinar software vendor to see whether they support playing video clips for attendees. Most products that rely on screen sharing recommend against showing a video clip playing on your computer. Listen to that advice. The typical screen sharing just can't keep up with the fast pixel redraws of full motion video. If you're going to try it, do extensive testing, preferably with a test attendee on a mobile device using a Wi-Fi signal. That performance could be a lot different than you see on your office's high-speed broadband connection. If your webinar platform is built to handle video clips, it probably uses one of two methods. One method is to connect each attendee with a video playback service, such as YouTube. In this case, the video must be available on YouTube, and you'll have to plan ahead and upload it to your YouTube account if you're trying to show a file from your personal computer. The other method is to have you upload a clip from your local disk. In this case, if you're starting with a YouTube clip, you'll have to download it to your computer first before you can upload it to the webinar. Once you have your clip ready for use in the webinar, you should run more technical tests. Check how the audio works. If attendees are allowed to listen to your webinar via telephone, does the video clip audio play back through the phone? You might be surprised to find that the clip audio only plays through attendee computer speakers. In this case, you'll have to tell telephone listeners to turn on their speakers before the clip starts playing and turn them off again afterwards. You'll also have to be careful to mute your presenter phone lines to avoid feedback from their computer speakers while the clip is playing. You should also check for synchronization issues that crop up between the video and the audio. If it's bad, you may need to warn your attendees ahead of time. Some presenters want to pause a video while it's playing, make a comment about it, and then continue with the rest of the video. Test this very carefully to see if the video pauses in the same place for all viewers. If not, your presenter could end up commenting on something she sees on her screen while the attendees are paused on a completely different frame. Well, let's say everything checks out technically. What else do you need to keep in mind? Well, remember that watching video immediately puts your audience into passive mode. You'll need to fight this by telling your viewers what they should be watching for, why it's important, maybe even give them a challenge or something to think about for discussion afterwards. Never just start a video playing without an introduction. And then try to keep your video clips short. You want to get back to your conversational mode as quickly as possible. Do some editing to condense your video to just the juicy bits. Now that we've covered pre-recorded video, you might like to check out my tips for appearing live on camera, which you can access by clicking here. Of course, the index page has the full selection of topics. Thanks for watching.